one of your questions, and I have the pleasure again of speaking to Dr. Françoise Wilhelmy de Toledo, who is the scientific director of the Buchinger Wilhelmy Clinics in Germany, Lake Constance, and in Marbella, Spain. Hello again, Françoise.
Hello, Lisa. Hello, everybody.
Françoise, thank you once again for taking your time. We have another very interesting question that popped up, and that question today is, what are the advantages and disadvantages of long-term fasting versus intermittent fasting? And I'm already looking forward to hear your answer.
I think both are complementary. It's focused on the metabolic switch. You know, if you do short-term fasting or long-term fasting, what happens is that you switch like a hybrid car from burning the materials which are in the food you absorb, you know, mainly glucose, and you have a glucose metabolism, you switch to the fats which are stored in your adipose tissue. So you switch from the nutrition from outside toward the nutrition from inside. It's called the metabolic switch. You have also a switch in your old genes programmation, so you will really change the programs. You can do it for a short period, like if you do intermittent fasting, maybe 16 hours or even 14 hours, according to how large the last meal was. You can reach that point of the metabolic switch in 10 to 16 hours, more or less. And this triggers the autophagy, which is the cell cleaning. The cells put themselves in a protected mode where they just eliminate the damage and old structures. And after that, you have a regeneration of the cell structures and sometimes whole cells. If you repeat that every day, then you end up with a very good cleaning system. It's a little bit like if you do every day 20 minutes, 30 minutes of exercise. And it trains also your metabolism. You can make metabolic training like you do a muscular training when you do this little workout every day. The good thing is that you can do on your own. You can do it at home, and it's very compatible with everyday life. You can eat very early, the last meal in the evening. This is the best pattern. But if your social meal is in the evening, then you can skip or make the breakfast a little bit later. And you have then the whole night plus some hours in the morning where you don't eat. And this leads to this ketosis, you know, the metabolic switch leading to ketosis, burning the fat, triggering the autophagy, and then the cell regeneration. You can do the same, but instead of eating after 2 or 3 hours or some hours, then you leave some days where you stay in this ketosis situation, in the switched metabolism before you switch back. And the longer you fast, the deeper the effect of the fasting. There are some effects, for instance, in enhancing the antioxidant capacity of the body, who only appear after more than 5 days. And for instance, to lower the blood or the high blood pressure, you need sometimes weeks until this really happens or it's determinant. So longer periods of fasting put you in this extraordinary ketosis situation. If you do a long-term fasting, you need 2 or 3 days to really, that your system adapts, especially if it's the first time. And then you can just remain in this ketosis situation. You enjoy the moments where you don't have to think about eating. You forget it, you are not hungry. So even if it's a little bit of lack of a pleasure, you get wonderfully accustomed to that. And if you do it in a good setting, like our clinics, then you have so many other pleasures in life, like the pleasures of having time of reading, of having a nice talk, making exercise, going to nature, making walks, just the things you have no time to do normally, and taking care of your body and yourself, maybe thinking about your life, reorienting it. So long-term fasting is not only short-term fasting, like intermittent fasting, just a bit longer, but it brings the dynamics that are going extremely deep in your body, in your organism, in your metabolism, but also in your psychism and in your soul probably. So we have three big groups to recommend long-term fasting. It's metabolic diseases, obesity, high blood pressure, hypercholesterolemia, and all these hyperlipidemias, diabetes type 2. So all the dysmetabolism, or sometimes all these symptoms happen at the same time. And also if you want to stop smoking, long-term fasting is an excellent way to do it. And then we have all the inflammatory diseases. And of course, if you do intermittent fasting, this is going to help a bit. But if you do a real long-term fasting, 10 days or 15 days of fasting, and then you switch back and do some days of a very good nutritional refeeding, I mean, going back to the food, then you have really long-lasting effects on everything that is ending with itis, arthritis, polyarthritis, gastritis, colitis, the allergic diseases, asthma, everything that is inflammatory. And we also have a big group of people doing long-term fasting because of just pre-burnout or exhaustion, you know, psychological exhaustion, physical exhaustion, the accumulation of lifestyle mistakes that lead to put on weight, to be tired chronically, and to have the impression, okay, I cannot go like this anymore, I have to make a stop and interrupt this vicious circle. So this is the advantage. The disadvantage of long-term fasting is that you need a setting and you need people to take care of you, because it's something where you need support, and most of the time you need also a group. So it's a group action. This is why the religions who still do fasting don't do it always right, but they still have the tradition. It's always a group happening. And this brings the group together. It consolidates a community. So it has incredibly many facets in the long-term fasting. So you can train your metabolism by doing regularly intermittent fasting, and then have this extraordinary experience of long-term fasting in an appropriate setting with an appropriate program. And in our case, we have this more than 70 years of clinical experience. We have, of course, a big team of medical doctors, but a staff with all the paramedical competences. And at the same time, we document scientifically the results. And you can read our last publication. They will be in the description, and you will see you can do with one stay of maybe 2 weeks or 3 weeks, you can really reset so many things in your person at metabolic level and at the soul level too. So just do it, try.
Thank you very much, Françoise. And I have to ask you another question. I hope you allow it, because I saw so many people guessing about your age and saying they would love to look like you when they are your age. So maybe you can reveal the secret and tell everybody about your personal fasting protocol.
Thank you first. I'm 67, and I discovered the fasting with 17. My medical past is very, very heavy. So I have had a lot of disturbances when I was 18, very severe ones with severe side effects. And this is why I pay a lot of attention to my lifestyle. First thing I learned when I was sick and ill myself, thanks to an extraordinary female doctor called Dr. Kusmin in near Geneva, my hometown, is the importance of healthy nutrition. And I never will never forget, this is the basics of everything I know in medicine. And so I do that myself. And the beginning was not easy, because when you're young, you have a very important social life and you go out, and but some of it you can always implement. And I relatively quickly changed to biologic or organic food. That's the basics. But the longer I live, the more, the less I need things I loved before, like sweets and like chocolate and like maybe complicated gastronomy. I like simple things with very good oils and vegetables. We have a region here on the Lake Constance, which is fantastic because so many organic farming. So we're very, very blessed with that. And I do yoga, which is also one of my pillars. And I have a faith and a very intensive internal life with praying, meditation, and values you want to live according to. And maybe after having preached to my patients 40 years what they had to do, I end up doing it myself.
So you're fasting regularly yourself too, right?
Yes, I fast every year, but not so long now because of the age and because I always take care of a group at the same time. So 12 days. Before, when I was younger, I used to do 3 weeks without problem, one or two times a year. And I always have a very restricting nutrition in April. This is the month where I have an allergy. It's an allergy to birch. And so I make a very restrictive nutrition, very raw, and with little quantity of different foodstuffs. And this keeps me going without any drug. I'm not cured from my allergy. It was a late acquired allergy. But I don't care because when April is finished, the allergies are finished, and the next year I do the same. So I put myself in a protected mode, and apparently it's helping a lot.
I do have exactly the same experience. I also have allergies, and then when I have intermittent fasting protocol during this month, I don't need to take any drugs. So very interesting. We've experienced the same fabulous results of fasting. So thank you once again very, very much, Françoise. It was extremely interesting again. And everybody who has a question, feel free to just post it below this video. And we put a lot of interesting links in the description. So feel free to check them out and get in contact with us. And I'm already looking forward to the next Q&A session with you, Françoise.
Thank you, Lisa. And thank you, everybody. I hope you join us soon for the next episodes. And thank you also when you make comments and maybe inscribe yourself in our circle. Bye-bye.
Thanks. Bye-bye.